Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. I'm Bishop Stacie Fidlar of the Northern Illinois Synod, and I want to wish you a happy Easter. I love the version of the Easter story in the Gospel of John that begins with the first verse of the 20th chapter. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. While it was still dark. She came to the tomb while it was still dark. She came expecting nothing more than hostile guards, tired and cranky at a cold dawn. While it was still dark and she was still grieving and wondering where everything went wrong. While it was still dark, carrying spices and her hearts and her loss and her fears. Was she ready to face this again? Her fragile spirit. She went. She went alone, or she went with others. The tradition is different, but she went while it was still dark. And while it was still dark, the world flipped upside down and everything changed. She ran back. She told them. She let them know what she had found. And while it was still dark, they ran back with her, finding that empty tomb with cloths folded. The others left, and she stayed there. She stayed, and she gets confronted by an angel. An angel rather than cranky guards or a big stone. She gets confronted with Christ and an angel, and Christ came to her while it was still dark. Because that's when Jesus comes. While it is still dark in our places, in our lives, in our homes, while there are still shadows about, Christ comes. Christ is risen. Christ comes while we are still struggling. Christ comes while we are afraid. Christ comes and is resurrected and sent loose into the world. That's the gift of resurrection and new life. Mary came thinking everything was lost, always. And yet, Christ rose. Yet, the light shined in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. Christ is risen. He is risen and set loose into the world, into all those places where our fears and our anxieties and our hopes are waiting to be born. Fear and anxiety washed away, and hope rising in an empty tomb. That's what we celebrate today. The promise that no matter what, Christ is risen. The promise that no matter what, new life comes. The promise of an empty tomb and a risen Lord, that death never gets the last word. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Go out into the world knowing that Christ goes with you, that he is everywhere where you don't expect it, that the surprise comes, even in those places where it still seems shadowed. Go in peace, celebrate Easter, and trust that God goes with you. Because Christ is risen. Amen and Alleluia.